I'm Kang, and I can't sleep. Hey, Benz. Today, you're going to hear a lot of and today we're going to talk about Shreddage. And I've been asked quite a bit how I make my Shreddage tracks sound more realistic, less robotic. I'm going to go over that today. You know, this sample library is really beneficial. It comes down to, you know, can you quickly and efficiently demo? Can you quickly and efficiently lay down a release? Which I've actually heard of people releasing full albums using Shreddage. It's not unheard of. And today I'm gonna show you my process and some of the things I do to get the sounds that I get. We're gonna primarily focus today on just the programming side of things. I'm not really gonna go into writing or like editing or anything like that. No kind of mixing either. It's just gonna purely be how I program and how I add more realism with said programming. So without further ado, we're gonna head to the other desk and get to it. So here we are at the session file for this is the Splatoon song by my band Zoroldo Kang. I just dropped a MIDI file in. So over here we have bass, drums, LSDJ, and nano loop. These are just synth files. If you don't know what those programs are, they're just I've recorded them. So without the guitar, this is what we're looking at. Cool. So now we're gonna go over some basic stuff I did to Shreddage to make it a little more in line with rhythms, because we're gonna focus on rhythm guitars today, not so much leads. We're working with really synth heavy music that's gonna take the lead role, so I just use kind of the guitar as an extra texture. Makes it feel more like metal. Obviously that's the point, it's metal. So normally I use two instances of Shreddage, and I'll pan one hard left and hard right, and then, like, you know, a real dirty breakdown or whatever, I'll add like a third guitar mono and detune it a little bit. But for the sake of this video, I'm just gonna hit this double stereo double button. So here in Engine, normally when you load this up, it'll default with the release noises with the pitched and unpitched on. That's really good for leads, and it makes sense when you're programming a lead, or I think more importantly when, because I know a lot of keyboardists get this plugin and they just play their keyboard and it sounds like a guitar and it's super realistic, and I love it. But we're doing rhythms today, so we're gonna take these off, because I would edit the crap out of the guitars to get rid of these noises. So I'm just gonna skip a step instead of having to edit something that I program. I'm just gonna go ahead and turn it off. And then normally it comes with extra pick turned on. That's good for leads as well. I'm gonna turn that off. We're gonna keep legato the same. And that's our basic setup. So let's go ahead and give it a listen, where I'm at so far, and I'll show you some of the programming techniques. So here we go. So
Here is, like I said, this was just a MIDI file dropped in. I masked the other sounds with some plugins, some sample libraries, and then this is Shreddage. So some programming techniques I did was, for instance, instead of making a power chord like this, and then, you know, you use the velocity, you turn that down, it turns it into a palm mute. So we'll go ahead and solo this. You know, it makes a power chord and it works. And when I first started using Shreddage, this is how I did it. You know, straight from a MIDI file that I made in like a Guitar Pro or Tablet or something like that. And I would drop it in and I would leave it just like that. And I would go through and turn all the velocities down to make these chugs. Well, they have a key switch right here. C sharp in the first octave. And what you do is you put that, so if we go all the way up, I have that right before that first note, the first note. And what that does is it's going to change this into a power chord. They got a sample bank for just power chords. And then right here, there's another key change to turn it back into sustains. So it turns it back into this chord that I'm playing. So it goes from power chord, sustain, back to these little choppy power chord guys, and then back into sustain, and then, you know, so on and so forth. Another thing to notice, I just highlighted all of these power chord chugs that I have in here. Notice the velocities. I noticed this with a really good guitarist that I was recording. He's super dynamic. His downstrokes were powerful. His upstrokes were a little less powerful. And that I kind of tried to emulate that kind of idea. So here we have, you know, powerful, less powerful. And then these, the lower you get, the more choked it gets as well. So I turn these way down because they're really fast power chords. Okay, so you notice how small they are. They're 16th note. They're really, really small notes. Playing that, you would be frantic in, especially in a live situation. It may not always sound chunky. It'll just sound kind of choked. So I kind of emulated that by turning these down even more. You know, and then once I got a good 4-bar edit going, I just kind of went through and copied and pasted it. And then, you know, there's this, here we got some triplets going on. I deleted those. But so there's the difference in edited and not edited. So you can see that's really static and really just kind of flat. Opposed to, okay, so let's move on. Here we have a little area where there's some kind of tremolo style picking. So I would go through and kind of, once again, upstroke, downstroke idea. One's going to be a little softer, one's going to be a little harder. I'll go through and kind of emulate that. And then another thing to notice that I programmed in here, you notice how these notes here don't just stop. They kind of continue. Well, Shreddage has this built-in function, legato, and it sounds more realistic. When you're playing a note and say you want to go up to the next, you probably wouldn't want to do semitone, but maybe two semitones up. You're going to slightly, I mean, even though here it is literally just a semitone, that was a bad example. Anyways, you'll go up a semitone here, and as you do that, you're kind of doing a slight kind of hammer-on effect. That's just how a guitarist plays. Sometimes you can be really clean and you can avoid this, but especially in a fast riff like this, and the chaos I would assume would be brought from playing this live, I could see it being a little sloppy. So we got some legatos through here, and I pretty much every note has been connected, or every change in note has been connected. So here, go ahead and turn these off, show you before and after. Okay, so, and then we'll turn these back on. So you notice it kind of has that hammer-on pull-off kind of effect. And, you know, kind of the difference between adding these velocity changes and not. You know, that sounds really flat, not exciting or anything. So that had a lot of motion to it. You got to think about that kind of stuff when it comes to programming guitars. You don't want it to be flat and motionless. It'll translate straight through the music. So here we got a little breakdown part. Once again, we're doing some power chords. We're going to go ahead and get rid of, obviously, this note, the high note. And we're going to use this as the base of our power chord. So those are pretty high power chords. They're pretty high up there in register. And I would assume that if this was being played by a real guitarist, they're going to be, they're not going to sound as chunky. So we're going to turn down the velocities. This might be a bit too much. You kind of have to play with it, but that sounds pretty decent. You know, and I was kind of trying to go for a djinty sound here. You know, so we're gonna go through, and you notice I'm doing the immediate next 16th note is a little tighter. It's a little quieter. Once again, that dynamic guitarist I keep talking about. And I'm going to go ahead and instead of programming the rest of this little breakdown section to be dynamic like this, I'm just going to show you what happens as it reaches here. It might be a desired sound for you. You might want that kind of robotic, kind of like cyber grindish sound. That's fine. That's, you know, do you. But this is the stuff I do. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the transition. So you can see there's a lot of realism that's going on here. Let's play this in context with some music. You could see that, even without me showing you where it was at, you could see that kind of sound, that transition from kind of realism to this robotic mess. Let's one more time. Yeah, you can definitely see what's going on there. So we went over legatos and how that can add realism. We went over velocities and how that adds movement, and we went over kind of the programming basics when it comes to rhythms and turning off your release note and your extra pick. You don't need those. Matter of fact, one of my biggest pet peeves when I hear a Shreddage sound, and I can instantly tell right away, my buddy pointed this out to me, that guitarist I was talking about, he pointed out, when your breakdown's hitting, why is there a slide sound at the end of every time you have a syncopated like chug pattern? I wouldn't slide after I'm just hitting some open notes. Why are you sliding? It's a dead giveaway. So just turn all that off. You're going to sound great. I guess we'll head back over to the other desk and finish this up.
And we're back. So that was pretty fun. You saw the different ways I use, you know, key switches and velocity to add more dynamic substance within all those riffs, breakdowns, whatever. Adds more motion if you really stick to adding that velocity differentiation throughout all of your riffs. It's just the small subtle things, and really that you can apply that to anywhere in music. It's the small subtle things. Every little thing adds up to one big picture. So don't be lazy. Just go through, add your velocities, keep in mind your key changes. There's plenty more key changes, by the way. I just went over the ones I use more often than not. There's like staccatos, and there's sustained power chords instead of the mutes, mute staccatos, so on and so forth. There's a lot of really fun key changes that you can add a lot of flavor and variety. So like, comment, subscribe. It's a new channel, my first video. I'm hoping it's only up from here. We'll see. So if you have anything you want me to go over in a future video, definitely comment. Go down into the comments and let me know. This is kind of informal and not really, you know, the best setup in the world, but we're gonna make it happen. It's more about the substance in these videos, not so much about the luxurious atmosphere, I guess. So anyways, like I said, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.